the problems, cyber anti-patterns. In this patterns and anti-patterns, you are going to learn what is the difference between that, what is which will create a problem towards your systems or your network. All those things we'll see in the module 4. Okay. In this anti-patterns concept, patterns were invented by the Christopher Alexander in the book A Pattern Language. That is, patterns resolves forces and yields benefits. If you are understanding the what pattern it is, see, normally patterns are invented by the Christopher Alexander in the book A Pattern Language, and this patterns resolve the forces and yields benefits. So if you understand whatever the pattern it is going on, if you can understand it easily, you can find out the what is the problem. If continuously if you are getting the same type of input, then it will find out, it can easily be easily found out by seeing the pattern of input. Okay, that's why pattern can resolve the forces and yields the benefits. Okay, anti-patterns generate mostly consequences but contains the embedded patterns, that is refactored solution that resolves the problems. Anti-patterns are, it will find out the pattern and it will stop that pattern to give us or get into your systems. Okay, that is anti-patterns. You can see that forces in cyber anti-patterns, context and causes, you can take it as a patterns. If you have an anti-pattern solution for that, you will be seeing the symptoms and consequences, and refactored solutions will be given, and you will get the benefits related solutions, and you will resolve the consequences. All those things you can go under anti-pattern, cyber anti-pattern forces. Okay, and in this cyber anti-patterns templates are micro anti-pattern templates, that is minimal structure, simple to Christopher Alexander's original invention. Whatever the original invention was, the simpler than that one, you have a minimal structure. That is micro anti-pattern template. Full anti-pattern template, you can see that in that you will be having the anti-pattern name, also known as, means some other different type of names will be there, no? That also will be there. Refactored solutions name. Oh, what are the refactored solutions are there? Its name also will be there. Unbalanced primal forces will be there. And anecdotal evidence will be there. Means previously what all the things has been done, and anecdote evidence are there. With respect to that, you can also take a solution, or you can also implement your solutions. Background, what all the backgrounds are there. Anti-pattern solutions, what all the solutions are there. And causes, symptoms and consequences, what all the consequences you can face by getting this pattern into your system. Known exceptions, what all the exceptions are there. Refractor solution and examples on related solutions. All these things will be present in full anti-pattern template. If you are going for micro anti-pattern template, in that only miniaturized structure will be there. If you are going for full anti-pattern template, all these factors will be present. Easily you can understand what all the problems you can face by getting this type of patterns into your system. That's why full anti-pattern templates only we can see. And here you can see cyber anti-pattern catalog. See, some of the example we can see which will be acting as a cyber anti-patterns. First is can't patch dump, okay, and unpatched applications, never read the logs, networks always play by the rules, and crinky on the outside, googly on the middle, and webify the everything, no time for security. All these things are the examples of cyber anti-patterns. One by one, we'll see with detailed anti-pattern format. Okay, how it will be represented, what all the details are there, all those things we'll see. Okay, with respect to cyber anti-pattern catalogs. Patch dump, second one is unpatched applications. Never read the logs, networks always play by the rules. Crunchy on the outside, GUI on the middle, and webify everything. No time for security. All these things are one by one cyber anti-patterns. One by one we'll see. First one is can't patch the dump. Okay. And this this will be human end users are always almost always the greatest vulnerability. Human end will be having the problem with respect to this type of anti-patterns, that is can't patch dump. Human can, for example, click on unexpected mail attachments. See, some of the theft mails or some other mails will be there, which will be affecting your system after clicking onto it. Virus mails, all those things will be there. These type of can't patch the dump, these type of anti-patterns will be created or get affected by towards your system by the human being end or human end users. Human can, for example, click on unexpected mail attachments. Sometimes they can click on the unexpected mail attachments and be susceptible to phishing and use easily guessed passwords. That will also be a human problem. And visit drive by malware website and malware cements means which some of the advertisements are there which will give you a problem after clicking on it or after getting into it. That's why if you are getting into some of the drives which through the malware websites, that will also give you a problem. Okay, end users education is a cure. Okay, always whenever you are see, human should know, they should get training with respect to what type of or they should have a minimum basic common sense related to that. What type of mails he should access, what type of mail should not be accessed, and which type of drive should be accessed through the secured websites. Okay, you should not get in, which type of the website you should not access, these type of things, and how to set the password and how much strong it should be, how to make the your password stronger. All those things you will be seeing related to this can't patch the dump anti-pattern method. Next you will see the actual format of these anti-patterns also. Okay, one by one we'll see what is the problem you will face by these type of anti-pattern, who will be getting these problems, all those things we'll see now. This is unpatched applications. In this, security researchers and attackers are consistently researching for the new vulnerabilities in the software. Okay, security researchers will be checking related to how to provide the security for this type of new type of attacks. Okay, attackers will be checking related to how to break these type of security things. Okay, and they will be checking for new vulnerabilities, how to get into your system, what is the loophole in your system to get in. All those things you can see this unpatched applications. That is, any software defect is a potential vulnerability. If you are in your system, if any software defect occurs, that may be a potential vulnerability to your path towards the path for the attackers to attack your system. In software testing theory, most any defect can be manipulated to crash the program. Any defect in the software or hardware, whatever the program is running, that can manipulate or can be manipulated to crash the program. Typical software applications are shipped with the tens of thousands of known defects, not to mention latent defects. And application patching, particularly on patch Tuesday, is one of the most important defenses. And next is never lead the logs. Network devices, operating systems, system services, and applications all generated logs equal to records of events. See, all the network devices never read the logs, and all the network devices, operating systems and system services and applications all generates the logs, records of the events. It means whoever logged into your server, who are logged into your websites, all those things are maintained in the form of logs, input logs, output logs, when he has logged in, when he has logged out from your system or your whole website. All these informations are maintained in the form of logs. Okay, and consolidating and reviewing the logs, that is using the tools such as system logs, is a critically important security activity, because whenever you are checking related to those logs day by day, actually day by day, if you have to check, or after 1 hour, after 12 hours, you will be checking this with respect to those logs. Okay, if you are checking related to the logs, who the unwanted person or the attacker, who the attacker or the unauthorized person login can be verified or understood by seeing the logs. Okay, it is said that all the evidence is in the logs. Always you will be having the evidence in the logs, means who has logged into the system, when he has logged in, and when he has logged out. If he has logged in, what all the data he has accessed. If he has not logged in but he didn't access any data, or he has injected some amount of data, all those things you can see in the logs only. That's why everything will be present in the logs. That's why it will be acting as a evidence for the system, means how the attack has been occurred, or how the who has attacked your system. If there is potentially malicious activities such as a repeated failed login attempts, that facts much that fact must be detected urgently and acted upon. See, continuously one person is trying to log into your system or log into your website, but he is not able to log in, means it will be normally taken as a attacker has done a attempt to do continuously login into your system or website. Okay, next we have networks always play by the rules. That is one key reason why network services are vulnerable is because they expect actors using the service to play by the network rules, that is established protocols. Always whenever the net or you are going to access to the network or access to the website through the network services, always you will be having some of the network rules. Whenever you are logging in or whenever you are accessing the websites or anything through the network services, always you have to follow some rules. Okay, those things are that's why always you can see that network will be always following the rules. Malicious actors means malicious attackers or users purposefully disobey the rules when they attack the system. Normally when they are attacking the system, they have to check for the bypasses, check for the shortcuts to log in. That's why they will be disobeying the rules of the network. Okay, and sending a very long input value containing the code to attempt the buffer overflow. Okay, if you are sending the very long in containing input code to attempt the buffer the overflow, to buffer the overflow, you are going to sending the very long input value and sending the segment of SQL code as an input to try the try trigger an SQL injection attack. If you are sending the SQL code, whenever you wanted to give the input of your username and password, at that time, if you are injecting simply a SQL code, it will trigger the SQL injection attack. At that time, you can get into the system. That's why some of the injection attacks or some code input, that will be done by the malicious attackers. Right? Pretending to be a wireless access point to gain the trust of mobile devices, for example, Karma and Karma Spotlight and Wireless Attack Toolkit. All these things are wireless access point to gain the trust of the mobile devices. You will be having these type of wireless connections. Okay. Next is crunchy on the outside, gooey on the middle. And traditionally, network security for enterprises has focused on the internet boundaries. Normally, internet boundaries are taken as a highest strength for your protecting your overall industrial connection. Okay. But hardened front-end services in the DMZ, internet-facing firewalls, and internet-facing intrusion detection and prevention. That is outer layer. Okay, if you are taking an industry as an example, overall industrial security, overall to get into the industrial website, to get into the one system, that will be a very biggest problem or biggest secured layer. Okay, hardened hard front-end services for, with respect to DMZ and internet facing firewalls, higher security provided by using this firewalls, internet facing intrusion detection and prevention has been done at the outer layer. Okay, once the problem is when once the attackers have penetrated the internet boundary, defensing are often very weak. For example, after getting off that boundary is very high level of security is there. But if any one person has penetrated through that security boundary, then internally it will be very weak. The security is very weak and the attacker can take out all the restricted data. That is the main problem with respect to this type of security. That is crunchy on outside and gooey on the middle. And once the attacker have penetrated into the internet boundary, defenses are often very weak. For example, ready intranet access to the servers with restricted data and restricted data not encrypted. Administrative users who use same username password for the multiple mission critical systems. See, and mission critical database readily accessed from the intranet. See, intranet means internally the each and every system which are interconnected by one person to another person inside the industry. That is intranet. Okay. If the person attacker has crossed the main boundary of the your industry, he can access each and every system. See, if he can access one system, through that system he can access any server. And if he can access the administrator system, administrators will be using the same username and password for the so many different type of critical system. Easily he can access all the mission critical systems and easily he can hack all the systems in the overall industry. That is the main problem related to this type of anti-patterns. Okay, that is crunchy on the outside, gooey on the middle. And Webify everything, that is some basic web attacks includes the cross-site request for gray and cross-site scripted attack, man in the middle attack. When the privilege administrator interface in Webify, the system become highly vulnerable to these type of attacks. Webified electrical power control system console and webified heating ventilating air conditioning console, webified network device or system administration console. With respect to see if all the administration related work or all the work each and every system person is doing, is if everything is webified, the system become highly vulnerable. Okay, the any person who is accessing the website, they can get into your system if everything is webified through your system. That's why everything can be accessed by the attackers. Okay, next is no time.